The 19th most common question asked by the non-Muslim is that if we study most of the religions, they teach us to do good things. Not to rob, not to cheat, not to rape. So if all the religions teach good things, why should a person only follow Islam? It's a very good question. That if we analyze, most of the religions speak good things, basically. So why follow Islam? The reply to this question is, I do agree, most of the religions speak good things, basically. But the difference in Islam is, Islam shows you a way how to achieve that state of goodness. For example, all the religions say you should not rob. Hinduism says you should not rob. Christianity says that. Islam says the same. So what's the difference between Islam and the other religions? The difference is Islam shows you a way to achieve a state in which people will not rob. Islam has a system of zakat. That is every rich person who has a saving of more than the nisab level, more than 85 grams of gold, he or she should give 2.5% of his excess wealth in charity every lunar year. If every rich human being gives zakat, poverty will be eradicated from this world. There will not be a single human being who will die of hunger. After this, the glorious Quran says in Surah Maidah, chapter number 5, verse number 38, as to the thief, be it a man or a woman, chop off his or her hands as a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Chopping off the hands, in this age of science and technology, in this 21st century, Islam is a barbaric religion. It's a ruthless way of life. I'm asking a question. That today, America happens to be one of the most advanced countries in the world. But do you know, it is the country which has one of the highest rates of theft and robbery. I'm asking the question that if you implement the Islamic Sharia in America, in USA, every person who's rich, who has a saving of more than 85 grams of gold, should give 2.5% of his saving every lunar year in charity. After that, if any person, man or woman, robs, chop off his or her hand as a punishment, I'm asking the question, will the rate of robbery and theft in America, in USA, will it increase? Will it remain the same or will it decrease? Increase, remain the same or decrease? Decrease. It's a practical law. You implement the Sharia, you get results. You implement the Sharia anywhere, doesn't have to be a Muslim country. You implement in USA also, you'll get results. That is the reason I say Islam, besides speaking good things, shows you a way how to achieve that goodness. And many people think that if you go to Saudi Arabia, where this law is practiced, every second person you come across will have his hand chopped off. I've been to Saudi Arabia more than 50 times. I've not come across a single person whose hands have been chopped off. There may be some people whose hands have been chopped off, but it is not as common as you think. The law is so strict that a person will think 10,000 times before robbing. And if you relax this law, if Saudi Arabia stops this law, Islamic law, immediately you'll find that robbery and theft will increase. Not that the police is very intelligent, but the law is so strict, the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you relax this law, even in that country, again, theft and robbery will increase. It is a practical law. You implement the Sharia, you get results. Let me give you one more example. Most of the religions say that molesting a girl is wrong, raping a girl is wrong. Hinduism says that, Judaism says that, Christianity says that, Islam says the same. So what's the difference between Islam and the other religions? The difference is Islam shows you a way how to achieve a state in which people will not molest or rape any woman. Islam speaks about the system of hijab. Normally, you read books, you find orators, scholars talking about hijab for the woman, hijab for the woman. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran first speaks about the hijab for the man and then for the woman. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 30, say to the believing man that he should lower his gaze and guard his modesty. Whenever a man looks at a woman, if any brazen thought, any unashamed thought comes, he should lower his gaze. Once, there was a Muslim who was staring at a girl for a long time. I said, brother, what are you doing? It's haram in Islam.
He told me, our beloved prophet said, the first glance is forgiven, the second is prohibited. I have not completed half my glance. That does not mean you look at a woman for 10 minutes without blinking and saying, I have not completed my glance. What the prophet meant was, if you unintentionally look at a woman, don't look at her again to feast on her beauty. The next verse speaks about the hijab for the woman. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 31, say to the believing woman that she should lower her gaze and guard her modesty and display not her beauty except what appears ordinary of, and draw a head covering over her bosom, and display not her beauty except to her husband, her father, her son, and a list of mahram, the close relatives who she can't marry is given. The basic criteria for hijab as far as the extent is concerned is that for the woman, the complete body should be covered. The only part that can be seen are the face and the hands up to the wrist. And it's mentioned in the Quran, in Surah Ahzab, chapter number 33, verse number 59. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O Prophet, tell your wives and your daughters and the believing women that when they go abroad, they should put on the jilbab, they should put on the cloak so that they shall be recognized and they will be prevented from being molested. Quran says, when the believing woman, when they go abroad, they should put on the jilbab, the cloak, so that they shall be recognized and it will prevent them from being molested. For example, if there are two twin sisters who are very beautiful, who are equally beautiful, and if they are walking down the streets of Dubai, you know, maybe Jumeirah, and one twin sister, she is wearing the Islamic hijab, complete body covered, except for the face and hands up to the wrist. And the second twin sister, she's wearing the Western clothes, mini skirt or shorts or with a low neck. And if both of them are walking down the streets of Jumeirah, and if round the corner there is a hooligan waiting to tease a girl, I am asking you a question, which girl will he tease? Will he tease the girl wearing the Islamic hijab or will he tease the girl wearing the Western clothes, the mini skirts or short? Which girl will he tease? Which girl? The one wearing miniskirts or short? Quran rightly says that hijab has been prescribed to protect the woman, to prevent them from being molested. And after this, the Islamic Sharia says, if any man rapes a woman, capital punishment, death penalty. Non-Muslims say, capital punishment, death penalty? In this age of science and technology, Islam is a barbaric religion. It's a merciless way of life. I ask these non-Muslims, and I say, that suppose God forbid, someone rapes your mother, someone rapes your sister, and if the rapist is born in front of you, what punishment will you give him? And believe me, 100%, all of them said, we will put him to death. If someone rapes your mother, you want to put him to death. Somebody rapes somebody else's mother, you say death penalty is a barbaric law. Why these double standards? Today, we look up to America as the most advanced country in the world. Do you know, according to statistics of USA, it is one of the countries which has the maximum rapes in the world. As I mentioned earlier, in 1990, according to FBI report, every day 1,756 cases of rape took place. If you see the other statistic, 1996, 6 years later, US Department of Justice, every day 2,713 cases of rape took place. Maybe the American got more bold. Every 32 seconds, one rape is taking place in USA. Every 32 seconds. I have given this lecture for the past 1 hour. Already more than 50 rapes may have taken place in America since the time I'm giving the lecture. And do you know, what do the statistics say? 1990 statistics say that in the full year, in 1990, 102,555 rapes took place. Only 16% were reported. Therefore, the exact number of cases you multiply by 6.25. You get the reply of 640,968 rapes took place. Per day divided by 365, 1,756. But the report continues. Out of the 16% that were reported, only 10% were arrested. That means 1.6% of the rapists were arrested. Out of those arrested, 50% were let free. That means only 0.8% underwent the trial. 50% were let free before the trial. That means 125 rapes you commit, the chances you'll undergo a trial is one. Very good gamble. 125 girls you rape, and chances you get a punishment is one. Who wouldn't like to try? And the statistics tell us that the judge says, first time he's committed rape, okay, give him only 1 year punishment. More than 50% get 1 year imprisonment, though the law says 7 years rigorous imprisonment. But the judge is lenient, first time he's done. 125 rapes. You get caught once, judge says, first time, 50% of the cases, he says less than 1 year. I'm asking the question, if you implement the Islamic Sharia in USA, any man looks at a woman, any brazen, any unashamed thought comes, he should lower his gaze. After that, the woman, they should properly be covered, complete body covered, except the face and hands of the wrist can be seen. After that, if any man rapes a woman, capital punishment, death penalty, I'm asking the question, will the rate of rape in USA, will it increase? Will it remain the same or will it decrease? It will decrease. It's a practical law. You implement the Sharia and you get results. That's the reason one of the least states of crime in any country in the world, it's in Saudi Arabia. Why? You implement the Sharia, you get results. That's the reason I say that Islam, besides speaking good things, it shows you a way how to achieve the good things. So the other religions are more theoretical. Islam is a practical religion. So practically, if you care for humanity, practically, if you really want the evil to be destroyed in this world, you have to accept Islam.